In our previous lecture, we have covered our chapter that was the early effects of radiations or the deterministic effects. And now we will start our new chapter, that is the stochastic effects or the late effects of radiation. So the response or the effect will be chronic, while the response was acute in the deterministic effects. So in our today's lecture, we will cover the local tissue effects. That will cover the local tissue effects of the skin, the chromosomes, and the radiation induced cataracts. We will start with the introduction. And the late effects in the diagnostic radiology are of particular importance. Why? Because the dose that is delivered in the diagnostic radiology is intermittent over the long period of time. So definitely the chances of the late effects are very important. The principal stochastic effects that we have previously discussed are the radiation-induced malignancy and the genetic effects. By increasing the dose, the response, the incidence of the response will be increased, but note the severity. So the response of the stochastic effect will be linear and non-threshold. The studies of large numbers of people exposed to a toxic substance require the considerable statistical analysis, and such studies are called the epidemiological studies, and they require the number of persons affected, and that number would be small. But we cannot conduct these studies in those people who are exposed to the radiation. There are two reasons for this. The first one is because the dose is usually not known and we presume it to be low. And the second reason is that the frequency of response is very low. So if we analyze these observations, then definitely the results will not be authentic, and we do not want the false conclusion. That's why it's not possible to conduct these epidemiological studies in the patients who are exposed to the radiation. Now we will talk about the local tissue effects on skin. In the deterministic effects, we studied that the deterministic effects can cause the erythema and desquamation, but the late developing carcinoma can be associated with the late effects or the stochastic effects. But it's not always necessary that the chronic radiation of the skin will result in the malignant disease. It can be severe non-malignant changes as well, and the one example of it is the radiodermatitis that was noticed in the early radiologist many years ago, who performed the fluoroscopic examinations without wearing the protective gloves, and they developed a weathered appearance, discolored skin of their hands and forearms, and that skin was tight and brittle, and they termed this condition the radiodermatitis. But recently this condition has not been noticed, maybe because of the advanced protective guidelines that we follow. The next is the effects on the chromosomes. The radiation of the blood forming organs can produce the hematological depression as an early response, or leukemia as a late response. So the effect of radiation onto the blood forming organs can be leukemia. The types and frequency of the chromosome aberrations, we have previously discussed these aberrations in detail, and we know that these aberrations can occur on a very low dose of radiation, but it's not always possible for these effects to be visible until many years after the radiation exposure. For example, individuals who irradiated accidentally with very high radiation dose can continue to show the chromosome abnormalities in their peripheral lymphocytes for as long as 20 years. So you cannot always detect by the appearing signs and symptoms that these effects have either occurred due to the low dose or the high dose. Even at the low doses, we know that aberrations, chromosomal aberrations can occur, but these low dose responses cannot be visible for a very longer period of time. On the other hand, if a high dose has been given to a person, then that person will continue to show these chromosomal abnormalities in their peripheral lymphocytes for as long as 20 years. So this late effect is presumably occurs because of the radiation damage to the lymphocytic stem cell, and these cells may not be stimulated into the replication and maturation for many years. So that's all for the chromosomal aberration associated with the stochastic effects. Now we will talk about the cataracts. And the cataracts basically in the 1932, the Lawrence of the University of California developed the first cyclotron, and you are already familiar with the function of the cyclotron. Cyclotron is nowadays is basically used to produce the radionuclides specifically for the PET scan with the use of cyclotron. We produce the fluorine 18, that is a radionuclide used in the positron emission tomography. So what cyclotron physicists did, they used a tool. They used a tool of the radiologists, that was the fluorescent screen, and we are already very well familiar with the fluorescent screen. And by using the fluorescent screen, they add in the location of the high energy beam. But unfortunately, due to that, they had to look directly into the beam, and it resulted in the cataract formation. And the first report of the cataract was reported in 1949 in the cyclotron physicist, and by the 1960s, several hundred cases of the radiation induced cataracts were reported. And another important point is that the radiation induced cataracts occur on the posterior pole of the lens. The development of the cataract is age related. The radio sensitivity of the lens of the eye is age dependent. So the older the individual, the greater will be the radiation effect, and the shorter will be the latent period. The latent period varying from 5 to 30 years have been observed in humans, and the average latent period is approximately 15 years. Lastly, we will talk about the doses that are required to produce the cataract. The dose response relationship for the radiation induced cataracts is known linear threshold, meaning that there will be a dose required to produce the cataracts, and if the lens is given a high dose in excess of approximately 1000 rad, then the cataract can develop in nearly 100% of those who are irradiated. Many investigators have suggested that the threshold after an acute X-ray exposure is approximately 200 rad, and the threshold after the fractionated exposure that we receive in the radiology is probably in excess of 1000 rad. The occupational exposures to the lens of the eye are too low to require the protective lens shield for the radiologic technologists. It is nearly impossible, they say, for a medical radiation worker to reach the threshold dose to produce a cataract. Those patients who come for the head and neck computer tomography or for the fluoroscopy, this is of particular importance that in those patients, this threshold dose can be given to the patient to produce the cataract. The lens dose can be 5 rad per slice in computer tomography. So, in either case, the protective lens shields are not normally required. However, in the computer tomography, it is common to modify the examination to reduce the dose to the eyes. So now we will summarize our today's lecture. We started with the introduction of the stochastic effects. Then we talked about the local tissue effects on the skin, and we said that the observed effects, the deterministic effects on the skin were the erythema and the desquamation, and the late development can be carcinoma, but this is not always the case. Sometimes the chronic irradiation of the skin can result in severe non-malignant change, and we then took an example of radiodermatitis that was developed many years ago in those radiologists who worked in the fluoroscopy without wearing the protective gloves. But now there is no such case has been noticed. Next, we talked about the chromosomal aberrations, and we said that the chromosomal aberration, as we know, can occur not only at high doses, but it can they can occur on the low doses as well. But at low doses, the effect may not be seen for a very longer period of time. And on the other hand, at high doses, the effects can stay for as long as 20 years. And the example we studied was the peripheral lymphocytes. Next, we talked about the cataracts, and we studied that in 1932, the Lawrence of the University of California developed the first cyclotron, and we know that the cyclotron are used principally to produce the radionuclides for the use in the nuclear medicine, especially the fluorine 80 for positron emission tomography, and later many other institutes developed their own cyclotrons. Then the cyclotron physicist used the fluorescent screen to add in locating the beam, and for that they had to look directly into the beam, and by 1949 the first radiation induced cataract case was reported, and by the 1916, several hundred such cases were reported. The radiation-induced cataract bilocation occurred on the posterior pole of the lens. Then we talked about the doses for the development of the cataract, and we said that if the lens dose is high enough, in excess of approximately 10 GYT or 1000 rads, then the cataract can develop in nearly 100% of those who are irradiated. And some investigator has suggested that after an acute X exposure is approximately 2 GYT or 200 rad, the threshold after the fractionated exposure, such as that received in the radiology, is probably in excess of 10 GYT or 1000 rad. So the cataract can develop. The occupational exposure to the lens of the eye are too low to require the protective lens shield for the radiologic technologies. So it is nearly impossible for a medical radiation worker to reach this threshold dose. And in those patients who come for the head and neck imaging in the computer tomography, and those who come for the fluoroscopic examination, the lens dose can be of the threshold value to produce the cataract. Especially in the computer tomography, the lens dose can be 5 rads per slice. So in either case, protective lens shields are not normally required. However, in the computer tomography, you need to modify the examination to reduce the dose to the eyes. So that's all for today, and if you have any question regarding our lecture, then you can ask. Thank you so much.